Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing the Double Rainbow YouTube Hop, and there are several very talented YouTubers that are going to be hopping along, so I have listed those in the comments section below, and I hope that you have a chance to check out all of the participants. So I am using these stamps from Pink Paisley, these butterfly stamps, and using some permanent ink from Pink Fresh Studio. And the reason I want to do that is because I am going to be using some watercolors and I don't want my ink to run. Now, I am not preparing my paper with any gesso or anything like that. I'm not going to be using a lot of water, and so it really doesn't warp my page. So I'm going to start by adding just a little bit of color here, and I'm not going to be really exact because I am going to actually run the color around the butterflies. So I'm just gonna kind of add a little bit of a base color, just a little bit heavier. And then you'll see as I go along, I'm going to go ahead and smear those a little bit. So I don't care if I'm really exact, I'm just trying to add in some extra colors. And when I thought about the concept of a double rainbow, I wanted to really bring in a lot of different elements. And so I wanted to do some rainbow colors in my background and in my embellishments. And so to me, that's kind of how I interpreted the double rainbow. So it will be in also kind of my title as well. So I'm really going to try and use a lot of different elements here. So once, and here's where I'm actually smearing that watercolor. I really love using watercolors. They last so long and there's so much you can do with them, and they just add kind of a fun feel to them. So I'm just smearing that around. I'd added a couple of little spritzes here and there, and now I'm going to go ahead and back my photos while I'm waiting on that to dry. These were some pictures we had taken at the zoo a couple years back, just having some fun with some photo ops. And so now that I have that, I'm going to take my heat gun and dry this. And now that it is dry, by the magic of editing, I'm going to add my photos here. So I've got those photos, and I just decided I wanted to do a very up and down design. And I'm going to pull out all of the butterflies that I have in my stash. These are some stickers from Hip Kit Club. And I actually have a baggie that I have separated out a lot of different butterflies. I know there are some Vicky Booten. I'm not sure where they all came from, but I'm just trying to kind of add them. And I am going to use some adhesive squares and pop dots to add some dimension to my layout, and just kind of put those all along where I stamped. And so, like I said, I'm going to put some pop dots up on the wings so it kind of looks like they're flying off my page. So these are also kind of a transparency from Hip Kit Club, and I really didn't want to use all of the different colors, but I did try to find some that I thought might work. And I'm going to go ahead and glue those down as well. Kind of looking at it now, I feel like I probably could have added some more. I've got some acetate butterflies. I probably could have added a few more colors here as well. But I just kind of stuck to the butterflies that I chose, and I'm okay with that. I think it worked out just fine. And I have some wood butterflies. I believe I actually got those on Wish. And these are kind of the last of my stash that I have of those. And I've honestly just really kind of enjoyed them. And so now I'm just kind of rearranging where I want these to go. I did have some come off the edge just to add a little bit of interest. And I have some words, and this is where I want to add another kind of rainbow element here to my page. And I apologize, I didn't realize I was out of frame for some of this, but I'm just kind of adding in just some fun words, some just fun titles, Just to kind of describe the day, it was just sort of a whimsical, fun thing to do, and I just wanted to go ahead and add that in. So I'm looking down at the bottom and wanted to add a couple more letters, words down there as well. Just having fun, just fun like that. And now my final embellishment is some sequins from Rachel Tallman, and I will put a link to that store down at the bottom as well. This is the I believe it's Peter collection, and it has a lot of really cool greens and some gold. And so I'm just kind of going to scatter those around my page and just add a little bit to my cluster here and there. I just think it adds just a little bit of pop of color, and I really like it. Now, one of the things that you won't see on camera is that I am going to add a border to the right and left side of my layout. I looked at it and it just felt like it was bare on the sides. So you'll see that coming up. So that's going to be about it for me. Check out my final layout as well as the close-ups. And I hope that you have enjoyed our video. I would love if you could subscribe to my channel. And if you like the video, give me a thumbs up. That would be fantastic. Make sure you're hopping along with everybody. There's some super great layouts to see, and I hope that you get a lot of inspiration. So take care, everyone, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye.